Hi everybody, my name is Hope and I'm the owner of Designs by Hope Yoder. In our company, we produce machine embroidery designs, sewing patterns, and everything SVG. I'm so excited to be here for this webinar and I want to show you what we're going to be working from today. We're working from an embroidery collection of mine. It's brand new and it's called Patriotic Pride, or actually Patriotic Puff Foam. So today is all about using puff foam. I'm going to go over some of the misconceptions about using puff foam, how you properly use it. I'm actually going to stitch one of the designs so I can show you some tips and tricks. And so let's get started. So some of the things you're going to need, well, let me show you this first. I'm going to be working on the design American Pride. Memorial Day is coming. And if you were born in the United States or you're a citizen, who doesn't want to celebrate USA. So with this, we've got three colors of puff foam that we're going to use: red, white, and blue. If you happen to be fortunate enough to own an embroidery design that can embroider on hats, wouldn't you look fetching wearing something like this at your next picnic? So here's the supplies that I use to create this. You're going to want some puff foam, and you can buy puff foam in multiple colors, or you can buy it in single sheets. So here's a great multi-pack, and you can see all the different colors. So there was red, white, and blue. I've taken it out of this package. The next thing that I'm going to use is, I love pink. It's my favorite color. Can you tell? If not, you'll see as soon as we're done. So we're going to be using this embroidery perfection tape, and this is great for all your embroidery needs. What makes it different than painter's tape, if you're wondering why would I use that? Well, I use it because it is a lot stickier than painter's tape, and it doesn't leave a residue. So whether I'm using it on my digital cutter to tape material down to the mat or on the hoop, it's just my first choice. So that's one of the products. And then we have some puff foam. So just to show you, here's a little piece that I actually ripped away from the hat. And again, I'll show you the hat and see if you can figure out where this came from. If you guess the stars, you're right. The stars and the stripes. So when it was done, I ripped it away and there is white stitching right inside of there. So I've got some new pieces of puff foam, and if we come over to my embroidery hoop, I've already started the embroidery to speed things up on camera. But I do want to point out, when you get the Patriotic Puff Foam embroidery collection, inside you're going to find a printed direction sheet. So you don't want to forget to print that. And this is going to give you some inspirational ideas. If you own a digital cutter, the CD also includes my original artwork, the SVG file, so you can get clever and crafty. And at the end of the video, we'll show you something that you can do if you own a digital cutter. But inside of here, the designs have puff foam creations, and then they have some flat filled where you don't use any puff foam, and then there's one applique piece. So you're going to find all of your directions, and you're going to find some photographs on how to use that. And I have circled the order in which I'm going to lay the puff foam, and it's going to tell me directions such as, after I'm done embroidering color number one, which I've done here, then I'm going to lay my white craft foam over it. So let's go ahead and get started, and we'll do that right now. So I'm going to take the hoop off just so you can see this a little better. And my directions tell me to lay the white foam, and this is where the embroidery perfection tape comes in. You have to use this if you are embroidering on a hat. When you hoop a hat, it's curved, and the machine stitches like this. So really make sure that you use tape on the puff foam on a hat. I could probably get away without using it on a flat hoop, but you know, the minute I don't use it, that's when something bad happens. So we don't want that. I'm gonna lay this down over my previous stitching. I've got that there, and now I'm ready to thread with my white thread. So let me go ahead and do that. And we'll get this out of the way so you can see it. And we're going to use white thread next. Let me get this threaded so we can have some puff foam fun. So let's go ahead and stitch this out. And after it stitches for a few moments, we'll take a break and then I'll show you how to remove it. Perfect. My next color is going to be red. So for before I take the hoop off, I'm going to go ahead and thread with red because I get so excited when I remove the puff foam. I would hate to forget to change my thread. Has that ever happened to you? Maybe I'm the only one. I love to embroider. All right, so I've got that ready to go so I don't forget. And let me remove this hoop. And we'll come over here. And you can see that I've stitched white on white. So I'm going to remove the embroidery perfection tape. And actually, I'm going to stick it right on the side of my machine because you can use it again and again. So it is reusable. Now with this, you can see the stitching over here. Let me talk a little bit about puff foam. One of the things I want you to notice as I do each step, it's very important that you use the same color thread as the foam. You wouldn't want to use red stitching and white foam. And the reason is when a design is created specifically for puff foam, it's digitized differently. It's not quite as dense. And sometimes you'll see the craft foam underneath the stitches or in between the stitches. So it wouldn't look good. It would look like a really poor design if I had stuck a different color. So always remember to match your puff foam with a color of thread. And that's why having a pack that has multiple colors is probably your best bet if you don't already own any of this product. And then later, if you're doing a lot of designs, it does come in an individual color. So you can use that puff foam. All right, so I've matched my white thread with my white foam, and let's go ahead and remove it. And so you're just gonna tear it away, kind of rip it away. And notice I have the white foam in between this. And at this point, let's see if you can see the height of that. Now here's another tip. You could lay multiple layers of puff foam. This is about 2 millimeters, and you could actually stack 2 or even 3 layers to get a really nice high depth. Have you ever been walking around the mall and maybe you're in one of those stores where they embroider on hats? That fascinates me. When I'm with my husband or children and we walk through the mall and I see a hat going, I stop, I'm looking in, and my husband will pull me and he'll say, come on, Hope, let's move. Let's move along, because he knows I'm going to be mesmerized by that machine. I want to know what stabilizer are they using, what thread, and I just sit there and try not to drool. So if you've seen those type of hats, they're really raised. That's the same thing, the puff foam that's underneath. And you can even purchase puff foam sometimes in 6 millimeters. But if you can't find that, then add multiple layers. So I've got that done. And now underneath here, I'm going to go into my red layer. My directions tell me to lay the red next. So I'm going to go ahead and tape that down. And the red is going to stitch the stripes on either side of the white. So I'm going to just tape that down so it won't slide. And I'm ready to put it on. I've already changed to red thread, so I think I'm all set. Get this out of your way so you can see the magic happen. And we'll go ahead and let that stitch, and we're going to do the same process. We're going to let it stitch and we're going to rip it away. So excited, I have the red done. So we're going to go ahead and take it off. But again, I'm going to switch to my last color of thread, which is going to be blue. And so we'll do this. Whoops, I forgot to remove it. Did you notice that? I told you, I get so excited. So I'm going to back this up, and no worries, I've not done any harm. So we'll come back into the blue and let's take it off and see the layers forming and the height. So I'm going to remove this tape, and again, I can reuse it. And if you can see this, we've got the red. And here we've stitched the red. The white is hidden underneath. So check this out. Are you ready? The big unveiling. Can you see how that's ripping away?
Love it.
Now, can you tell why I'm in the mall, why I want to stop and watch those hats being done? And actually, I do have a machine at home that I can embroider on hats, which is wonderful. All right, so I've got my two layers done, and you can see the elements. Ooh, I did that almost without ripping it out. That's pretty cool. Now save these pieces because you may be able to use them elsewhere. And then we have our last piece of blue. Now the blue is going to go over the American and the Pride. So it's a little bigger piece, and I am going to center that down. And you know the drill from here. I'm going to go ahead and tape it just so it doesn't move. We're going to put this back on and we're going to let it continue. And then I'm going to give you some more tips and some more basic information about puff foam. Get this out of the way. So we'll stitch this and don't go anywhere because I've got some great information and tips and tricks or helpful hints from Hope. Perfect. All right. Yay. It's like Christmas Eve. You don't know what you're going to get until you remove the foam. So I'm going to lay this here, remove my tape. And I see a little thread. Oh, I saw it under the light. I should have cut it off while I could see it a little better. There we go. All right. So you've seen our two layers of foam that we've removed. So we've used three colors. Again, this is what we're going for. And if you can see this hat, it looks nice. We've done a little after treatment to the puff foam that I'm going to show you in a moment. So when I remove the puff foam, it's not going to look quite as good as my finished hat. So we'll talk about how to fix that. So let's remove our foam. And I'm going to carefully remove it all. Don't really want to rip it because I can reuse this on another design. And I will take that out. And then I'm also, going to want to remove the foam that's in the center. And you can see as I do this, we're revealing the flat red underneath. We don't want that, so let's just throw that offset here. Just like at home. Except this isn't my home, so I can throw it on the floor. Shh, don't tell them. They might be watching. So let's remove this here out. Take you a little moment to get everything out. And then we've got a couple threads to trim. I'll just do that real quick. And I'll trim it a little better later, but just so you can see the design. That looks really nice. And let me see if we can get a close-up of, one more little piece of foam here. And a little bit here. Perfect. And is there some here? You are probably rooting for me to get this all off. It's hard to see in the light here. So if I left a little, you'll forgive me. Now when I hold this up, you can see this looks pretty darn good, but sometimes you may have some threads where you can see the foam in between. And that's why, just a reminder, is you want to match the color of your thread with your foam. Now, one last little thing. Now, when we did the hat design, maybe I can show you a close-up. We used a different color thread. It was a little darker, but this was the same foam. And so in this area, if I spread the stitches apart, you can see a little bit of the foam underneath, which is a little bit different shade. And so to clean this up, now this, our thread matched a little bit closer. To clean this up, I have a little trick for you. So helpful hints from Hope. You can purchase one of these little heat burning tools. They're actually used in the scrapbooking world and you probably don't own one, but there's nothing special about this other than it's hotter than a blow dryer. So it's a little heat burning tool and I can actually shrink the foam underneath. by just rotating it. Now, I like to use poly thread. A little stronger, it's color fast. And I'm just gonna rotate this around, and what happens is the foam underneath will shrink and the stitches will fill in more. So if you happen to see foam underneath or sticking out a little bit, just give it a little bit of a try with a heat burning, not a heat burning tool, but a heat gun. This is used for embossing, things like that. You may have one that you haven't used for a long time if you're sewing, so it's a perfect place to use that. And I get asked all the time, can I use a blow dryer? Well, a blow dryer is not going to work. It doesn't get hot enough. So this is a craft type heat gun in our business where we shrink wrap our product so that when it gets delivered to your home, it's got a nice shrink wrapping. We use a heat tunnel or a heat gun. You could use that as well, except those get a lot hotter than your craft one. So quick recap on puff foam. Number one is you're not able to just place any craft foam underneath any satin stitch embroidery design that you purchased. When I digitized for puff foam, you have to digitize it specifically to use with the foam. And by doing that, I have to cap off the ends and do some special treatments when I digitize and punch the stitches so that at the end, it won't stick out. So what I mean by that is if you look at this letter P, on the end, it's straight. Now, if I just didn't have a design that was specifically digitized to use with the foam, the foam would stick out here. And even if you trimmed it off, it would still stick out because the digitizing stitches aren't capping it off. So make sure that when you intend to use craft foam, that the designs were digitized for that. And again, in the Patriotic Puff Foam, we've got several designs on this. Some of them are made for puff foam, and in the PDF file that you'll print, they'll actually say puff underneath. We may have the same exact design that we've digitized differently not to use with puff foam, and it would be flat. So on that one, obviously you're not gonna put the craft foam down. Now, there's a couple other things that I want to show you. So in a moment, we'll be right back and I have some more inspiration for you. Do you own a digital cutter? Well, if you do, you wanna pay attention. I'm gonna give you some tips and tricks to use this embroidery collection even further. So if you own a digital cutter, you may want to pre-cut out your applique designs. Something you may not know is in this collection that we give you the applique cut files in four different digital cutting languages. Number one, we have the Scan and Cut FCM. We also have the Silhouette Studio file. We have the Zing and the Artistic Edge file and the Eclipse 2 file. So all you have to do is copy and paste that and cut it out on your cutter. No need to design or create the cut file. That's all included with this collection. Now, isn't that great? That saves you a lot of time. But even more importantly, my original artwork that we digitized the embroidery design for, we put it all on the CD. And what that means is if you own a digital cutter and you want to get clever and crafty with it, I have given you the SVG files. And what you're going to do with them is what you see on the table. So let me kind of go through them and I'll show you how to make this cute little baby onesie with heat transfer vinyl. Number one, let's look at this Born in the USA design. So with this has no craft foam or puff foam like we just showed. But what it does have is this background is actually fabric. So if you own a digital cutter, then before you do your embroidery, you're going to fuse your fabric with a fusible webbing. My favorite is Applistick from Quilter Select. So I've got that ironed on. It has a nice waxy paper on the back, and I've left that on and placed it paper side down. Are you wondering, how am I going to remember all this? Well, let me give you a great tip. So we have this little box here that maybe you've noticed, and there's a friend of mine right on the cover of the box. Well, it's actually me on the box. So Hope's in the box, on the box. And what's great about this is all of these directions on how to cut out on your cutter, what blade setting, what cut speed, and what cut pressure. Craft and Cut will tell you all of that. So it's like having me home with you right by your cutter. So that might be something you want to look at later. So with the Craft and Cut, let's move this out of the way. It actually comes, it comes with that pink embroidery perfection tape that we just used. And it also comes with the applique fusible webbing that's on the back of my fabric. So back to the fabric. I'm just going to take the Scan and Cut cut file, because off camera we used a Scan and Cut to cut out the USA background. Now if you have a different brand of digital cutter, perfect. We've given you all the cut files for all the major cutters that you probably own or anybody watching owns. So you can see we've cut away the fabric, so I'm going to get rid of that. When I go to do my embroidery for this, it would stitch the outline for the USA. And then I would take this, and on the back, I would score it with something sharp, just like you do for a sticky stabilizer. I then, I'll score it a little more. I then would remove the release paper to reveal the sticky fusible webbing. And why this is my favorite, because there's a million on the market. And let me get this on their floor. Shh, don't tell. So with this, why I love this is if you're using pre-cut shapes for your machine embroidery, it's super duper important that you center this over the placement line. You don't have any extra room to trim, and that's what speeds things up and makes it efficient. So if you wanted to make some patches to wear for Memorial Day or Labor Day or 4th of July, you could stitch it on felt and just cut it out, put pins, where it is a necklace, whatever you wanted. You could knock out several of these by pre-cutting your shape and having a large hoop. So the other reason I like this is it is sticky. So that means by the time I put my hoop from the table back onto the machine and the presser foot lowers, it's not gonna blow or move or shift. Now, if that hasn't happened to you, that just means I've probably been embroidering longer, because I've had all kinds of mishaps happen when I used a non-repositionable fusible. So that's a little tip for you. And again, that fusible comes in this Craft and Cut box, or you can pick it up at your local dealer or at the end of the webinar here. So that is the patch for the USA. Now, this same design, Born in the USA, so this would be the embroidery design straight off the CD, and then the extra cut file that's a big time saver. But the original artwork, the SVG file, are you wondering what that means and what that means to you if you own a digital cutter? A lot of people ask, I get it that it's artwork, but what would I do with it? So here's one of our educators, Miss Lori, made this great little sample on a baby onesie. How stinking cute is that? Can you imagine a baby going home from the hospital having this cute little ensemble? So this would be great for a boy or girl. This is just a purchased little hoodie, and you know, the babies go home from the hospital having a cap on their head, and this is heat transfer vinyl. So this is another design from the collection, and this would be what it looks like embroidered. And this one does have puff foam. Made in America, and then there's the heat transfer version, which is using the SVG files. So let's put this all aside. I'm going to show you how you would create this Born in America design. So we'll put these all out of the way, and we've pre-cut on our digital cutter the three layers. Actually, you probably are going to want to see this as we have that here. So here's my white layer. Even though it's a white onesie, we've got the white layer underneath, and then we have a red and a blue layer, and it's cut at a heat transfer vinyl, and it's mirror imaged. So this is called weeding. When you cut vinyl, whether it's heat applied or sticker, you're going to weed it. Cut it, and you weeding away means just what it says. If you're a gardener, or you like to keep your lawn looking nice, then you're going to weed your garden, and that means you're going to remove the things that you don't want anybody to see, and you're going to leave in your garden the pretty things. Well, I'm weeding heat transfer vinyl. And so I'm going to remove the background, all the stuff that you do not see on the t-shirt. And when you do this, you can see how it's curling. So that is not reusable. You're not going to use it again. And in my letter E right here, I'm going to Go ahead and just take out that little center. Perfect. I like to use a little sharp tool here. And you could use a big T-pin that you probably have in your stash or a pin to get that out. And so that's the next layer that you see. And then the blue layer, you've used a little different color blue for this. I've got it started, so it's easy to show you on camera. Whoops. And I have just a little bit more to weed out here. And now to show you the three layers, you're going to take a t-shirt or a onesie, whatever you like. It doesn't need to be pre-washed. And you've got your USA. So you would press this onto your garment, the white, with about a 320 degree temperature, which is about a cotton setting. Press down about 5 seconds, and then you're going to remove this carrier sheet. There's a sticky carrier sheet. You're going to remove it so that you make sure it stays on the t-shirt. Next, you're going to lay down looks like I got a little area I just noticed that needs to come out. Next, I would lay down my blue piece over this, and so it would go over here. Press it for a few seconds, remove the carrier sheet, finally lay my last piece, and this time I'm going to press this for about 10 seconds so it all sticks together, and then when you remove it, you've got this little heat transfer vinyl on a onesie, and it's ready to wash and wear. Now, if you own a heat press, perfect, that's your best option, but you can use a regular household iron. So born in the USA, great American pride. You could blow the heat transfer vinyl or the SVG file up really big to put on an adult t-shirt. One last little tip before we go. If you want to put this on American t-shirt, or not American, if you want to make an Americana design for an adult size t-shirt, typically you're going to size your design about 9 inches. That's what they do in the commercial world. I hope I've given you some nice, helpful hints from Hope, and you've learned a little bit about using craft foam, puff foam with a design collection. If you own a digital cutter, then you know you've got double value in the embroidery collection Patriotic Puff Foam, because not only do you have all the embroidery designs, but you have the matching, coordinating original artwork, so you can get clever and crafty with vinyl.